Hello there, my, this is General Snivy, and welcome back to more Let's Play The Last Remnant. Today, we're going to be taking on a couple of new side quests. This one, we have to talk to this guy, and, well, he's kind of a neat freak. And not the kind of neat freak that you can tolerate. He's more like the, ew, what is that, a piece of, a little speck of dirt that's not even visible to the human eye, and it's like, oh my god, I must disinfect it with bleach and then smash it with a hammer. Yeah, he's that kind of person. Well, anyways, what he is having us do today is we're going to be returning to the Catacombs of Illusion. Reason is because we have to get some sort of seeds or something, and we have to get them after defeating a couple of Quincy's who were running around in the beginning area. It's a very easy and quick side quest, so it only takes about a few minutes. But anyways, what you have to do is lock on to at least 3 of the Quincy's who are running around this area within the first part of the area, and you should be able to get the seed no problem. Again, the key number is 3. You can go for 4 or more if there are that many in the area, but whatever, it's up to you. And that's it. Side quest is already finished. I chose not to show the battle because we've already seen the fight before, and we don't need to see it again as I go on a killing spree and kill everything in sight. I mean, sure, I still do that anyway, but still. This side quest, I wanted to get it done as quick as possible. And that's it. That's it for after a day's work. Like I said, very easy side quest. Now for the next one. What do we have to do? Just bump into this guy, and he is like this freaking drama queen. It's like, oh my god, you bumped into me. You broke my leg. Oh my god, I'm going to sue you. But at least he's not like one of those guys who screams, ow, help, my leg. Okay, I can't do that. I just freaking can't. Okay, so this guy is known as Darren. I hope I said his name right, but that's how I've always called him. Darren. In this side quest, we have to find this guy's hometown and retrieve the Holy Chalice. However, he's not going to necessarily tell you the location of his hometown unless you speak to him again. And when you do speak to him again, he'll actually give you a hint of where his hometown is actually located. If you can recognize the first 3 letters of that town, you know exactly where to go. So, we're heading off to a new location, and we actually need to go through 2 different locations in order to get to Darren's hometown. First up, this place. I call it the Green Dragon Canyon of Death. Well, maybe not. Not during the first playthrough, but definitely during hard mode, I call it the Green Dragon Canyon of Death. Reason? This entire area is infested with those freaking green dragons. And also these guys. These guys, well, let's say this. They come in huge numbers. By huge, I mean like maybe around a group of 2 or 3 per set that you encounter on the field, but still, again, much like everyone else in the game, well, maybe not, they're a pretty big pushover, but again, they're not necessarily that. So in essence, fight them if you want, they should be okay to take down. Not hard at all, just give it all you got and don't take on too many at once, otherwise you're going to be in some serious trouble. And also they do take quite a bit of a beating, so keep this in mind when you're fighting them. So let's see, what should I talk about today? Well, it is still November when I'm recording this, but this is being released in early December. Jeez, I'm that far in advance as far as recordings are concerned. Yeah, I went there. Deal with it. Okay, on with today's topic. you're not really going to care about this, and truthfully, I wouldn't blame you. I recently picked up Call of Duty Ghosts. I bought the Hardened Edition because I wanted to get the Hardened Edition of the game this year, because it looked really promising, and I feel like it is definitely holding up to its promise. Again, this is just the honeymoon phase, as described by many, many people in the COD community. And if you want to know what the honeymoon phase, it kind of goes like this. The honeymoon phase is when the game first comes out and everyone's praising the game, saying it's the best Call of Duty ever. And like about a month or two later, they're going to say it's the worst Call of Duty ever. That's pretty much how the honeymoon phase works. You love it for like the first month or two, and then for the rest of the year, everyone hates it. That's pretty much the life cycle of the COD games. No, really. It's funny, but still, it's pretty annoying too. So what else should I talk about? Well, I don't exactly have a list of topics to go off of, and to tell the truth, I'm bored. I'm bored right now. I don't know why I'm bored. I figured I'd give myself a little something to do, and decided to say, you know what, screw it, I'll just come in here and record some commentary for these videos, and bam! At least it gives me a little something to do during my pass some time. I mean, I could continue playing COD Ghosts, and I most likely will after I'm finished all these videos. I mean, including this one, I got 5 videos in total in order to record commentary for. At least it's not like last time when I had to record commentary for 7 videos and do it like 7 videos straight. Well, okay, maybe not 7 videos straight, but it is 7 videos nonetheless. Just thought I'd bring it up anyway. Now you may also be wondering about the length. Why is it almost 25 minutes long? Well, the reason for this being, I spent quite a bit of time in this area, and also these guys. The Green Dragons of Death, known as Arrow Knights. Like I said, this entire canyon is infested with them, and this could be due to the fact that my battle rank is so high at this point in the game. And many elitists are probably going to yell at me saying, what are you doing having such a high battle rank? Seriously, you're going to be in some serious trouble with a high battle rank. I say no! I don't freaking care, it's my Let's Play, I play however I feel like playing. And, yeah, deal with it. So the Arrow Knights, what can I say about them? They're dangerous, and they hit hard. And fighting just one on the field results in at least 2 or 3 of them in battle. I don't know why this is, but this is just the way it is. Another thing, these guys are incredibly dangerous if it wasn't obvious. Just taking on one of these Arrow Knights, you're gonna need to hit it like really, really hard. Hit it with some really powerful attacks and also protect yourself as well. If you have any Union members who know protection and Orphic Ward, definitely use it. Utilize it and cherish it. Seriously, you will not regret doing it. And just a single attack can really mess you up. Especially when these things attack multiple Unions at once. And they have a bit of a tendency to do that too, with Celtic Blast, and also that one attack that they fly into the air and then they blow some... How can I put this? They use like this Razor Wind sort of thing, or is it Gust? I don't know. Either way, very powerful attack, and it's also really annoying. So yeah, this is gonna take a while. These things, I freaking hate them. Cause one battle I can do relatively well and take them down in less than 2 or 3 minutes. And other times, I'm taking at least 10 or 15 turns, which results in around 10 or so minutes. I wasn't even really paying attention to how long it was actually going on, because I'm concentrating on fighting and trying to win. But either way, these battles can last forever. Hence the reason why I only showed a battle once. I mean, if I would have included every single one of these fights, it would have taken... this video would be over an hour long. No, really. What I've been doing was, I've been trying to divide my videos into like 1 hour recording sessions each. Just so Vegas doesn't throw a fit and say like, ooh, I'm not gonna work for you and blah blah blah, and end up messing up the video in several different ways the next week. That's what happens when it comes to long recording sessions. Occasionally, Vegas throws a fit. Most likely due to the fact that the RAM and the memory just simply can't handle it. But I recently increased my RAM capacity to 16 gigs from what it was originally before, which was 8. And that actually helped significantly. But nonetheless, it's still annoying to know that that is what's going on here. Also, I hate this guy. Why did I say that? I don't know. And also, that was one of the rare instances when, despite throwing down a special move, you actually get hit. Like I previously stated, your evasion is boosted to at least 90 to 95%. Again, don't quote me on that exactly, because that's just a pure guess. But I feel like it is around 90 to 95%, and the chances of being hit are relatively low, but you can still get hit sometimes. Alright, time to take another beating. But thank God protection was still in effect for a lot of people. So, let's see, what else should I talk about? Well, this battle is still going on, and it's going to be going on for quite a bit of time. At least for a little while longer, because we still have the one Aeronite group to deal with. And the single one, too. Like I said, Aeronites, if you are approaching them at this point in the game and you're not doing side quests, it is highly recommended that you avoid each and every single one like the plague. Because they will rip you to shreds if you dare to face them without the proper stats and stuff. Maybe they only appear around Battle Rank 50, Battle Rank 60, but I'm not 100% certain. Maybe they just don't appear at all during the main game if you're playing on the normal mode. I don't know. Your guess is as good as mine. I don't know why these things even exist or why they even appeared, but they're here, so we're here to fight them and take them down. Why? Because, I mean, we don't have to take on every single enemy here, but it's wise to do so. Even though elitists will probably say that's not a good idea. I say it is a good idea. I'm following traditional rules of traditional JRPGs. Because deal with it. I play the game however I want. It's my game, my Let's Play. I'll use it when I need it. Another thing with Aeronites, I just noticed, they seem to have a bit of a tendency to be highly susceptible to curse. Again, I'm not 100% certain, but that's just a guess. And no, I'm not trying to say I'm backwards. Guess.
Feel stronger than before!
For the glory of Asura!
Excellent.
There's still plenty of power left.
Well, that battle took a really, really long time, and I don't freaking care, but...
Come on out!
Anyways, we got more stuff.
Okay, later.
So, let's see, what else should I talk about? Well, I have recently started watching another new show. Well, it's not really new, per se, but... Still, I'm watching something new. In a sense. I'm getting into Naruto Shippuden. Yeah, I finally decided to jump into the sequel of Naruto. And by the way, I am enjoying Shippuden a lot. It's epic, and it's also sad at times from what I've seen so far. And, oh man, I just can't wait to see what happens next with each and every episode. And by the way, I'm watching the uncut version of the show. Yeah, uncut version. It exists. It's real. Just like ghosts. Ghosts that haunt your dreams. And Luigi. Booga 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 booga. Oh, jeez. I really am going on a random trip, aren't I? Or am I saying random junk? Yes, I am. Well, there's one more thing I could talk about. Remember a few videos ago I mentioned that I was using my mother's computer chair to sit, and due to the fact that my old chair broke up and gave out on me? Well, I'll get back to that in a second. This may look like the exit to proceed onward to Crookfin, which is the next area where we have to go to, but it actually isn't. It's an exit to another area, but we won't be able to access it until a much later part of the game. And I mean much, much later, like towards the end. And also at this point, the dragon started tearing me apart. Why, I don't know, most likely due to my battle rank. But again, I don't know for certain. To me, it just seemed like it was just so simple as bad luck. Bad luck happens to all of us. And that does come into play quite a bit. Oh shoot, what was I talking about before I got distracted?
Let's do this.
Oh man. I already forgot. Oh yeah, now I remember. Remember my mother's chair that I was presumably sitting on before? Well, that kind of broke on me too. I leaned back a little too far and I was stretching one morning while I was sitting down watching some stuff or something like that, I'm not sure. But anyways, I leaned back and then I noticed the chair leaning abnormally far back, and then I fell to the floor. So basically, the chair itself fell off the pole of which it was sitting on, and it just broke. I tried to put it back on, but it didn't work. So yeah, that chair is busted. So I had to go out to Walmart and buy myself a little folding chair. And it's definitely not the most comfortable thing in the world, but it beats sitting on something else that's also really uncomfortable and I can't sit on for more than a few minutes. This chair, it is slightly more comfortable, but not that comfortable. Either way, it sucks. And also, it is better than not having a chair at all. I mean, I can't really sit on my bed and actually type on the computer and stuff because I don't have a wireless keyboard or mouse, and besides, I don't really have anywhere to have them work. Well, actually, I do have a wireless mouse, but not a wireless keyboard. Besides, it's a bit inconvenient, if you ask me. Man, my butt hurts so much. It's because I've been sitting here for quite a bit of time. But hey, what can you do? Am I right? Gotta make do with what you got and what you can purchase with very little money. Well, I am hoping to get a new computer chair for Christmas, but I don't know. Because of our money situation, I may not get one. I mean, my mother has to get a new chair too for herself because I broke her chair. Which I still feel bad about, but still, can't necessarily be helped. Thankfully, my mother wasn't too mad about the fact that, you know, I broke the chair. And this was because I took the chair down to her after I broke it and just told her what happened. So, she was a little upset, but she wasn't mad like I thought she would be. So, here's a life lesson for you. If you broke something that belonged to like a family member or a friend, just tell them the truth. Tell them what happened. And I guarantee you they're not going to be as mad as they would be if they found out on their own and if you lied to them. So, yeah. Life lessons with me. I really am spewing out random stuff, aren't I? Yes, I am. I'm also hot. Sweaty. How am I so hot? I don't know. Probably because of the heat that is set in the freaking house right now. Well, no, it's not a house. It's an apartment complex, but you get the point. It's a little townhouse. Mm-hmm. Anything else I've been doing recently? Well, I've been searching around for jobs. Finally, I have an update on the whole job searching scenario. I didn't get the job at GameStop, which is really no surprise, but still made me disappointed and sad, but not too bad, actually, just disappointed. So, despite this, I'm just searching around, seeing what else I could possibly find. And I found a couple of jobs right now. I'm looking at Walmart and Best Buy to work temporary work for the holiday, but again, it is just temporary. I mean, if I do a good enough job, they may actually keep me, which would be really nice. But again, I need to see if I can find something for the time being to make a little bit of money and help my mother out in whatever way possible. I mean, I'm not trying to complain about my life being so horrible. I mean, it isn't. But if you don't really have much anything to talk about, well, here you go. Talk about random stuff in life. Deal with it. And this video is about to come to a close. Jeez. Can't believe I've been talking for almost 25 minutes. Well, this area, I don't know what I'm saying anymore. This area is finally done. Head to the other exit, and you will reach the next area of Crookvid. So, I'm out of time now. So, this is General Snivy with Let's Play The Last Remnant. Thank you guys so much for watching, and next time, we're going to be proceeding onward to Crookvid, which is actually a pretty nice area. Anyways, see you guys next time.